Hello everyone, welcome back to today's discussion on multiple choice questions of all the chapters of PUSP PU Business Studies. Now let us discuss the multiple choice questions of first module, Nature and Purpose of Business. In this, the first question is, which of the following is not a characteristic of business activity? We have options. Option A, production of goods and services, salary or wages, presence of risk, sale or exchange of goods and services. The right answer is option B, salary or wages, because option A, C and D, these three are features, but option B, salary or wages, this is not a feature. Next question is, which of the broad categories of industries cover oil refinery and sugar mills? Option A, secondary, primary, tertiary, none of the above. The right answer is secondary industries, option A. Next question, which of the following cannot be classified as an agribusiness to trade? Option A, insurance, transport, mining, warehousing. The right answer is option C, because mining, this is not related to agribusiness to trade, because it is a part of primary industries. Second chapter, forms of business organizations. First question, profits do not have to be shared. This statement refers to option A, partnership, B, joint Hindu family, C, sole proprietorship, and D, company. The right answer is option C, sole proprietorship. The Hindu undivided family head is called, or the head of the Hindu undivided family business is called option A, proprietor, director, karta, and manager. Option C, karta, is the right answer. Karta in a joint Hindu family business has option A, limited liability, B, unlimited liability, C, no liability for debts, and D, joint liability. Actually, option B, unlimited liability, is the right answer. A partner whose association with the firm is unknown to the general public is called option A, active partner, sleeping partner, nominal partner, secret partner. Option D, secret partner. Right answer. In a cooperative society, the principle followed is option A, one share, one vote, one man, one vote, no vote, multiple votes. Option B, one man, one vote. This is the right answer. Provision of residential accommodation to the members at reasonable rates is the objective of option A, producers cooperative society, B, consumers cooperative society, C, housing cooperative, and D, credit cooperative society. Option C, housing cooperative society, is the right answer. The structure in which there is a separation of ownership and management is called sole proprietorship, partnership, company, all of the above business organization. Actually, in a company, ownership is totally different from the management. Hence, option C is the right answer. Company. The capital of a company is divided into a number of parts, each one of which is called option A, dividend, profit, interest, share. Actually, share, the right answer, option D. Minimum number of members to form a private company is 2, 3, 5, 7. So, private limited joins that company, the right answer is 2, option A. Minimum number of members to form public company means public limited joint stock company is option A, 5, 7, 12, 21. Option B is the right answer, 7. Board of directors in a joint stock company is selected by general public, government agencies, shareholders, employees. Actually, board of directors are selected and elected by shareholders of the organization. Option C is the right answer. Next question, centralized control in MNCs implies control exercised by option A, headquarters, branches, subsidiaries, and D, parliament. The right answer is headquarters, option A. Next question, public sector enterprises are organizations owned by foreign company, transport, government, and a joint Hindu family. Option C is the right answer, government. Next question, reconstruction of Sikh Public sector unit is taken up by option A, Board of Industrial Finance and Reconstruction, Memorandum of Understanding, Ministry of Food and Agriculture, and D, none of the above. Option A is the right answer, Board of Industrial Finance and Reconstruction. Next question, disinvestment of public sector enterprises implies option A, choosing closing down operations, B, investing in a new areas, sale of equity shares to private or public, and option D, none of the above. Actually, option C is the right answer, sale of equity shares to private. Next question from the chapter Business Services. DTH services are provided by option A, transport companies, B, cellular companies, C, banks, D, none of the above. Option B is the right answer, cellular companies or cellular mobile companies. The contract of life insurance is option A, utmost good faith and insurable interest, indemnity, one-way contract, none of the above. The right answer is utmost good faith and insurable interest. Which of the following is not a type of banks? Option A, commercial bank, B, cooperative bank, C, savings bank, and D, central bank. The right option is savings bank. This is not a type of banks, but commercial banks, cooperative and central bank, these are the classifications. Savings bank, this is account. The next chapter, in this first question, e-commerce does not include option A, business interaction with supplier, business interaction with customer, interaction among geographically dispersed units, interaction with departments within the organization. Actually, option C is the right answer, interaction among geographically dispersed units. Actually, e-commerce doesn't deal with option C, interaction among geographically dispersed units. The next question is, a call center handles option A, only inbound voice-based business, option B, only outbound voice-based business, option C, both customer-facing and back-end business, and option D, voice-based and non-voice-based business. Actually, option C is the right answer, call center handles both customer-facing and back-end business. Next question, the payment mechanism most typical to e-business is option A, cash on delivery, B, check, C, credit and debit card, and C, D, e-cash. So here option B is the right answer, check. Next chapter, formation of a company. Here the first question, application for the approval of a name of a company is to be made option A, SEBI, option B, Registrar of Companies, option C, Government of India, option D, Government of the State. So here right answer is Registrar of Companies. Always for the application should be remitted, for the approval of company name is to be made to the Registrar of Companies. A proposed name of the company is considered undesirable if option A, identical with the name of existing company, closely with the name of existing, it is an emblem of Government of India, in case of any of the above. Actually, option D is the right answer, in case of any of the above. A prospectus is issued by private company, public company seeking investment from public, a public company. Option D, a public enterprise. Right answer is a public company seeking investment from public. Which of the following do not come under the types of hit and run retailers? Peddlers and hawkers, market traders, cheap jack, street stall holders. So right answer is option D, street stall holders. Which of the following is not a fixed shop large retailers? Option A, general store, chain store, mail order houses, supermarkets. So right answer is option A, general stores. The goods not suitable for mail order houses are option A, those which can be graded and standardized, those which can be transported at low cost, those which have already demand in the market, those which are perishable and bulky. So option D is the right answer, those which are perishable and bulky, not suitable for mail order business. Which of the following statement does not apply to a wholesaler? Option A, he buys in a bulk from manufacturers and sells in a relatively small lots. He undertakes buying and selling in their own name. He bears variety of risks. He acts as a link between manufacturer and consumer. The right answer is option D. He acts as a link between manufacturer and consumer. This is not the correct statement to the wholesaler. Next chapter, international business. The first question, in which of the following modes of entry does the domestic manufacturer give the right to use intellectual property such as patent and trademark to a manufacturer in a foreign country for a fee? Here option A, licensing, contract manufacturing, joint venture, none of the above. So here the right answer is licensing. Always licensing deals with patent or intellectual property. Outsourcing a part of or entire production and concentrating on marketing operations in international business is known as option C. The right answer, contract manufacturing. Here options are licensing, franchising, contract manufacturing and joint venture. Among these four options, the right answer option C. When two or more firms come together to create a new business entity that is legally separate and distinct from its parents, it is known as contract manufacturing, franchising, joint venture, licensing. So option C is the right answer, joint ventures. Which of the following is not an advantage of exporting? Option A, easier way to enter into international market, comparatively lower risks. C, limited presence of markets in our foreign markets, less investment requirements. So right answer is option C, limited presence of markets in our foreign markets. This is not an advantage of exporting. Which one of the following modes of entry requires higher level of risks? Option A, licensing, franchising, contract manufacturing, joint venture. The right answer is option D, joint venture. Which one of the following modes of entry permits greatest degree of control over overseas operations? Option A, licensing or franchising, B, only owned subsidiaries, contract manufacturing and last, joint venture. The right answer is option B, only owned subsidiaries. Which one of the following modes of entry brings the firm closer to international markets? Option A, licensing, franchising, contract manufacturing, joint venture. The right answer is answer D, joint venture. A receipt issued by the commanding officer of the ship when the cargo is loaded on the ship is known as shipping receipt, mate's receipt, cargo receipt, then carter receipt. So here answer is option B, mate's receipt. The document containing a guarantee of a bank to honor drafts drawn on it by an exporter is letter of hypothecation, letter of credit, bill of lading, bill of exchange. The right answer is B, letter of credit. Which of the following documents is not required in export procedure? Certificate of origin, certificate of inspection, mate's receipt and the bill of entry. The right answer is D, bill of entry. It is not required in an export procedure. Which of the following documents is not required in import procedure? A, trade inquiry, bill of entry, import general manifesto, certificate of origin. The right answer is D, certificate of origin. It is not required in import procedure. Thank you, my dear students. Thanks for watching. Do share, subscribe, and comment.